All right, today we're going to be isolating chloroplasts from baby spinach leaves. You can follow along in the methods in the module for the chloroplast experiment. I chose baby spinach leaves because I felt that I had a better chance of getting good chloroplast activity for our experiment in the next video. I've already teared my way boat, and I'm now just trying to avoid the veins as much as I can. I chose a fairly large way boat, and you'll see why in a minute. That doesn't look very good. So in order to get inside the cells and extract just the chloroplasts, it's going to take us several steps to get there along the way. And this is kind of the first crude step. And got a ways to go. You can see that I'm wearing my personal protective gear. Well, at least you can see my hands are. I'm also wearing my mask and a lab coat. Alright, so I'm just about done grinding my leaves into submission. You can see here, maybe, without me spilling it, there's very few identifiable leaves left. It's now just a green slurry. And we're ready to move that into a 50 mil conical tube. So this is a 50 mil conical tube. It's called conical because the bottom is cone-shaped, and it holds a maximum of 50 milliliters. So we place that in the rack. We get a piece of cheesecloth. Okay, we spun our spinach slurry for 1 minute at 200 times gravity. That's 200 times G. And that made the most dense things move to the very bottom of the tube and form a pellet. I don't know if you can see that. There's a darker green pellet at the very bottom of this tube. Okay, so here's the end of that 7-minute run at 1,000 times gravity, and you can clearly see there's our pellet full of our chloroplast. That's what we want. So I'm going to remove the supernatant and then resuspend that pellet in 2 milliliters of suspension buffer. Okay, so in this step, in this stage, we're going to measure the concentration of chlorophyll in our chloroplast suspension. We're going to use these 1.5 milliliter microfuge tubes because they fit into a very small centrifuge. Again, you'll see I have two of them. One's going to be for balance and one's going to be for chloroplast. Okay, so this setup should look fairly familiar to you from earlier in the semester when we did a little bit of practice spectrophotometry. We have the actual spectrophotometer here, and we have its computer control here. And I've set this up for, try to get the glare off that, 652 nanometers. Okay, and what we're going to do here, today we're going to be using low volume cuvettes. So instead of being perfectly square on all sides, you can see here they have takes a less volume to fill them because of that wedge. Okay, so that you don't need quite as much volume to fill these. So the first step here is to calibrate it, and I have a cuvette here with distilled water in it. Okay, and I will place that in here. Tap. So we're going to zero this to distilled water. Okay. It says calibration is completed, and sure enough, it's reading 0.00. So that's done. Next, we're going to take our chlorophyll extract and put it in this other cuvette and measure the absorbance. And I need something to write with. And you need something to write with. Because you're going to calculate the concentration of chlorophyll using the equation in the instructions, in the method section that you find in this module on Blackboard. You can calculate, first of all, the concentration of chlorophyll, and then you can calculate how much it needs to be diluted to 0.01 milligrams per mil that you have to get it to. Going to go pretty quickly once I get this started. Okay. And as I said, from that absorbance, using Beer's law and the equation with the extinction coefficient that you find in the methods for this lab, calculate the concentration in milligrams per milliliter of chlorophyll. The path length is 1 centimeter. You can refer to the video on spectrophotometry to go back over Beer's law and how to do that calculation. Once you know what that concentration is, then you can figure out exactly how much do you have to dilute it to get it to 0.01 milligrams per milliliter.